I can add, if you recall, in 2015, the government came up with some proposals, almost 22 things they wanted to give to the API industry. And they said that 15 will be the year of API. After that, nothing has happened. It's just remained on paper. So the API industry needs support from the government if you're talking about vis-a-vis China. Where China is supporting their API industry to the hilt. Land is almost free. Electricity is very cheap. Interest costs are cheap. They are given all the infrastructure facilities because huge plants are there. There are certain Chinese manufacturers who make only vitamin C and they make it in tons, thousands of tons. So nobody can compete with them.
You spoke about environmental clearance.
Are there projects that are pending environmental clearance in Tamil Nadu? Can you give some examples, names?
See, actually what sir said is, see, if I have an API company, I can manufacture 20 API in that, okay? So I will not be getting in the first day itself 20 product license. Initially, I would have got 5 product license. When I'm going for the 6th product license, how being a red category they have kept to us, we have to clear once again like launch. Like first time we'll go for the entire clearance. Stage 1, stage 2, like that for setting up of the industry. Now, pharma API industries, what they are asking is, there is a limit given to them. This much liter you can, if my ETP is capable of managing 1000 liters daily, I should be allowed to change any product and do it. But their system is not that way. Even for the 6th product, if you go and apply, it takes 2 years. This is a very peculiar thing. Why they have kept that system was, in red category means like some cement industry, which will have only one product. When setting up of a cement industry, they have to get clearance once. That same rule is not user friendly for API industry. So it is not that every time you go for a new product, drug control will give license, but pollution will not give you license. That is the problem.
Sir, are there any issues pending on pricing between IDMA and I think the NPP, right?
Where is
it? Yeah, there is a constant dialogue we keep having, which is normally one-sided. Now, NPPA traditionally wanted to bring everything under price control. But we kept on resisting that and government did support. But today, the government is also tilting towards supporting what NPPA does. So there is very little support for the industry. Now there is a, if you know, that all prices which are, all products which are out of the national essential list, we can go for a 10% increase annually. Now they want to say, no, everything that is manufactured by you, irrespective whether it is in the essential list or otherwise, will be only as per the wholesale price index. You cannot get this 10% price increase. So certain proposal we were able to nip in the bud, like there was a proposal coming up some months ago that what is your actual manufacturing cost, you should put that also on the pack. We said no, because that will create a lot of confusion in the industry, and instead of manufacturing products, we'll only keep answering to the press and to the NGOs and all that. And why it's not happening in other industry? Why only pharma? So they have nipped it in the bud. We have done that. But there are certain other things which we are just fighting and nothing is happening.
With respect to implementation of the price reduction, so what they are insisting, it has to be instantaneously reduced. The problem is to reduce it in the chemist shop, it becomes very tough. See, we have got control only on the product we have in the warehouse or the product which we are going to manufacture. So then, you know, then they may send notices that a particular chemist shop the price has not come down. But it has gone, there are 7 lakh chemists in India. So what we are requesting is from the next batch, we are ready to give the price reduction. And one product is going to be manufactured now. From the next batch, please implement a price. But they are not given a solution to this as of now. So even though people, genuine companies who actually are implementing from next batch, but they have a problem with respect to implementing in the various nook and corner of the country. We cannot put a label and all the affix stickers and all the things. this solution problem is not sorted. I even know.
Sir, I have just two final questions. One is about the Indian drug requirement. How much self-sufficiency have we achieved in terms of the Indian drug requirement? Can we say we are something like, you know, 80% plus? Where are the gaps? And the second question is about exports. They took a beating because of the perception of India as being very IP unfriendly after the Novartis case. Has the perception of India changed? And where are the real opportunities for Indian drug manufacturers? And if you are looking at any particular diseases where we are strong in, you know, the drugs.
Yeah, so there are two parts of the question. The first part is regarding the self-sufficiency. Almost with respect to the formulation, India is almost, I would say, 90% self-sufficient in the formulation. Even 90 or little more than that, you can say, because almost the imported formulations are very less in India. We are able to manage with the formulations which are produced in India. Only in the case of API, it's a problem, you know, of a dependence on China. So that is one aspect which has to be looked into. With respect to exports and all, there is now, you know, there's increased confidence. See, many of the companies, actually the problem has been not, there has been no finished product has failed. The observations given in the US FDA and all, there is no failure of finished product. They only questioned about the manufacturing, the GMP practices, and also the documentation and all these things. So those things, and then they call it the data integrity. Documentation is not complete, so they say data is not correct, may not be correct. So now many of the people, Indian companies, have seized with this matter and started training several people, personnel there with respect to these two areas. And even recently, IDMA has conducted a course along with a collaboration of NSF UK, where we have taken around first batch of 40 qualified pharmacists in India, and we have given them a training over five modules. Of each module is around 4 days. A 20 days training where the inspectors, UK NSF, who is training the UK majority inspectors, they came to India and they have given a training. So this is going on, and with the result now, there's the confidence levels on Indian products have definitely gone up now. That is one aspect of the thing. Other aspect of is that India, the advantage of India is not only it goes to the developed country, our products are going to the least developed countries as well. So we are able to manage, that's why it's called the pharmacy of the world. So we are able to manufacture on one side products on communicable diseases like anti-diabetic drug, cardiovascular drugs on one side. At the same time, we are able to give the non-the communicable diseases like tuberculosis, malaria and all, and anti-AIDS program, all those things getting manufactured. There's no big problem with respect to manufacturing from India. Future is very bright because there is no second player with respect to supply of generics to the world. India is number one, and any other country is a poor number two only. Because our competitor, China, is more in the API. He is now trying to get into formulation. So, but still there is a big gap between India and China with respect to formulations. And there are countries like some Mexico and some countries are there, now Bangladesh, but there are comparatively smaller players. So that's why US say one third of their requirements for generics, they are getting the supply from India. So future is very bright. In many countries India can supply. They have the capacity to supply.
IP protection
in India or outside?
India.
India is much better now. See, IP protection, as already said, now India is IP protected country. That's the old story. This all started, it is in 2005. Fully we have signed the treaty and all. We are fully complying with the patent regulations and all. Now many of the multinationals have started coming. They are introducing product here. Anti-diabetic drugs and vaccines. They are bringing a lot of things in India. The patent protection, there is no apprehension on the part of the foreign multinational. But even then, some of them may still say that there may be doubts and all, but I think there is no need for them to doubt.
We have to move on to the next program. And I thank all the press and media for the coverage. And I'm sure you are always our well-wishers. And Pidambaram is there for next 2 days. We can privately have your discussion. And
see what DDC
is, because it is not in the transaction possibility act, there is no mention about
the, yeah, what DDC said. What DDC said was, currently in Drugs and Cosmetics Act, the quality means it is the responsibility of manufacturing person, and whereas internationally marketing authorized persons are also responsible. So now India also, they are trying to bring such regulation, and in DTAP committee now it has been approved that marketing people are also responsible for their quality. Once DTAP approves, then it will go and will be part of the gazette, and it will become part of the law, then we have to be enforced on that. Yeah, that they will do, that is their problem, but it is initiated.
There are so many amendments taking place through the DTAP. Every other day there are amendments in the Drugs and Cosmetics Act, and this is one such amendment they have proposed.
Even otherwise, marketing professionals have got a responsibility to see their product quality is good.
Very important.
So even in our case, although we are getting it done outside, we are ensuring that our man is sitting in the plant or the outsourced plant and supervising that operation. Because tomorrow, if there is any problem,
it is not the, it is an equal responsibility. One cannot shut out the responsibility, neither the manufacturer nor the marketing company, which is not at the balance currently. Thank you once again. Thank you for being at our invitation, and we look forward to more your support and our collaboration. Thank you.